Everybody, Mikey-Ice right now. We're at Dolphin Park, which is in Carson, California, with Ramo from the legendary movie Beastly. And it's been a dream of mine since I was a child when I first seen Beastly, you know, to ask you some questions about the movie, because a lot of people have always been curious, you know. And, like we just mentioned, the graffiti part. You remember when you guys first came up on the train? And
that's right.
You know, you first had to do that. Like, when you were painting, like, you were actually painting in some of the movies, though, right?
That's right.
Can you share that with us?
Yeah, they trained me and practiced, so I could do the fill-ins and make the lines right. Mm-hmm. So when we did those scenes, I was doing the beginning. And then after they cut, and the set artist would come in and finish it.
So who actually did the whole piece where it says hip-hop, you don't stop?
That's a good question. You know, the set artist did that piece. Mm-hmm. We helped it, but they finished it.
Okay. That's so awesome. So how did they pick you to actually get the role, like, on Ramo, like, out of all the people they could have picked?
You know, I auditioned first for the role of Andy B. Bad.
Okay.
And I didn't even get to audition. And then I was lucky because I knew the Belafontes and knew Gina, I knew Harry. And they were kind enough to call me in and say, listen, you tried to get in that audition, but we wanted you to audition for Ramo. I was very surprised.
Okay.
So I went in audition. I got the role. Biggest surprise in my life. I didn't thought I would get it.
Yeah.
You know, because I knew Cy Morales and those guys were up there. So.
Oh, that's so awesome. So when they filmed the movie Beastly, were you there at the Roxy's when they had the battle scene with Rock City versus New York City Breakers?
Yes, I was.
And a lot of people say that, well, not a lot of people said, but I was told that it wasn't a real battle. From your point of view, did it look like a real battle, or it looked scripted?
It looked like a real battle. Those guys were fiercely dedicated and really, really strong. So they were on. I mean, it was wild to see.
So your opinion in that battle, who do you think won?
That's
the New York City Breakers.
That's right. The New York City Breakers.
The New York City Breakers.
Always.
Big time money makers. That's remember when that album first came out, they had you can pull out a poster. And all the tests of like Mr. Wave, and it had like a it was a step by step. You know, and on the back it had like the walls with the graffiti and everything. And I just remember you know, Beastly was just, like, after I seen that movie, because I live in a little town called Madeira. Madeira's a super small population. When I seen that movie, like I told you, all of us, we went to the sports store and we bought ski goggles. We had ski goggles on. Everybody had, like, you know, ski goggles, you know, puffy vests and stuff like that. But we was really inspired, you know. But, like I was saying, you know, earlier when I seen... Like when Lee was like, yo, Ramo's making us the baddest sweatshirts. So in my mind, as a kid, I was like, man, this guy must have a lot of importance, because like you were like, you to me, you had like the most parts in the movie, you know? So it seemed like the movie centered around you, you know? So, and then that infamous scene when you guys first seen Spit, you know? Later on, I from my research, they were saying basically that was Cap.
Cap. That's Cap. That's yes. Right. That character is based on Cap. He used to go over everybody's stuff. Yeah.
Right. So the guy that played Spit, like, who was that?
That was a guy named Billy Anagnos, and he was a stuntman.
Oh, a stuntman.
Yeah.
Okay.
And he walked me through everything that I had to do. He was a really nice guy. He, if you look at the mechanic with Charles Bronson, when the guy takes the motorcycle off the cliff, that was Billy at 16 with the motorcycle.
Okay.
So he came out here in California as a big stunt for him. Unfortunately, he passed about a decade.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
He's a great guy. Very, very nice guy.
Okay. Another scene in the movie Beastly, when he was walking and Lee's brother, what's his name again?
Kenny
was walking. He goes, Ramo. He goes, that's your baddest burner. And you look and he was like, it's okay. Like, who did that piece?
The same people that did, that's okay. Right. I think they call them scenic designers.
Okay.
So it's amazing that they got that piece on the subway, and then they moved. They had to stop the subway at two tracks and then pull it through because there was no digital. You couldn't project it onto anything.
Okay.
So that was really on the train.
Oh, nice. Yeah. Oh, okay, okay. Oh, nice.
And then they came to the next station and the shot was done and they wiped it up.
Oh, okay.
Because it was done in streets and hills.
Oh, man.
If you look, you see the shape of the cans and the
Yeah. Okay. Well, guys, I'm gonna speak to him again. I just want to do like a brief intro while I have him here. Next weekend we're gonna be at the B-Boy Summit. Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. If you'd like to meet him in person, we'll be there. We're gonna be having shirts. If you want to take pictures. And I'm gonna get more, like the second part of this interview, just wanna introduce you to Ramo right here. And I hope that you guys enjoy it. Peace.